for fame. Don't need no house on the beach, cause I can ride this train. Ain't got no car to drive you home. Ain't got no number, cause I ain't got no telephone.
Welcome to MLB The Show and this presentation of Minor League Baseball. Tonight, game two of this three-game series between the Northwest Arkansas Naturals and the San Antonio Missions. It's Baseball on the Show, and it's coming up next. Brian Mitchell will be on the bump for game two of the series. Dan, any thoughts?
Hey, this guy has a four-pitch repertoire, right? And those are a lot of nice options to have. You can go hard, soft. You can go in and out. And anytime you have four pitches, if you can throw them for strikes, you have the big advantage.
In now is John Jay, and he's looking to get it going. Off to a bit of a slow start this year.
John Jay.
Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Run as he rolls over it to second. Slugger. Throw in time and the side is retired. So not much happening here in the top half of the first. So it's on to the bottom of inning number one. No score. Into the box now. Professor Slugger. First at bat for him in this one. He was 1-for-4 with a double in the ball game last night. First pitch coming, here it is. Takes a fastball on the inside corner.
Hey, stay high, huh?
Oh, and one, here it comes. Popped him up. Morales in foul ground, and that's the third out. So it's no run on no hit, no errors, and a runner left. We'll go now to the top of the third, and we are tied 0-0. In now, Tomas Reyes, and he'll get his first opportunity in this one.
Tomas Reyes.
And a fastball swung on and hit to second. Comes up with it. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third. Ready for another chance? John Jay. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. Arroyo leads off second with nobody out. On the ground out to second. And that's the first out. Digging in to try it again, Adam Francisco.
The designated hitter, Adam Francisco.
Chops this one out towards second. Only play will be to first, as we'll see our first run score here, as this is a 1-0 ball game.
That's good hitting right there. Put the ball in play and let the guy trot home from third to put your team on the board. Good.
Digging in for his second at bat, Professor Slugger. His last at bat didn't go his way as he popped out in foul territory. He's ready. Here's the first offering. There's a knee-high pitch that catches the zone.
He's been pitching really well so far in this one as we cruise into the middle innings. One of the big reasons why, 80% first pitch strike ratio. If he continues that, he might be able to finish this one.
And there's ball one.
Hey, let it fly, let it fly, right?
The 1-1. Soft liner towards center. And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit.
Man, this guy's really starting to swing the stick again, D-Row. That extends his hitting streak to 9 games.
Yeah, he's leaking into three series right here now. Nine games, that's getting firm. He's seeing the ball well, and he's making the proper adjustments at the plate.
And now they've got him in a rundown. Poor base running there. Got him caught in a hot box between first and second. And they will tag him out between first and second. Digging in once again, Peter Morales. He flew out in his last at bat.
Peter Morales.
The 1-2. Down the third baseline. To second for. On to first, and you can forget about the go-ahead run being on base. He's erased on the double play. Digging in and looking for more, now Professor batting. Slugger. He singled his last time up.
Professor Slugger.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Line toward center field. And that falls in for a solid base hit, his second of the night.
Don't sleep on the bottom of the order right there. He broke out all ambush tactics. First pitch fastball, middle in, and he's able to drive that thing nice.
Riding in once again, Henry Barrios.
Henry.
Possible go-ahead runs on first, one away. Runners off for second. This is line to left, and that's in there, base hit.
Wow, that's surprising right there. Hit and run tactic used to perfection. False hit to the outfield. The batter does his job. I don't know how that runner's standing on second still. You tip your hat to the outfield to get it in super quick, but he's got to take the chance to get to third.
Trying to pick things up where we left off, Frank Rivera. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here. 0-2 count. Here's the pitch. And here's a swing and a miss. And that, folks, is a big out number two.
That was a big strikeout there, guys. The best pitchers have the ability to strike guys out when they really need to. And that second out was really important at this point of the game. Could be something we look back on later when the game's over.
Now batting.
Settling in now, Matt Caesar. Two outs and two runners aboard here in the seventh inning. Here's the 0-2. Skied into straightaway right. Jay has a read on it. He hauls it in, and the potential go-ahead run will not come around to score. So it's no runs on two hits, no errors, and two men left stranded. Eighth inning coming up. All tied at 1-1. Ready once again,
now
Professor
batting.
Slugger.
Second baseman, Professor Slugger.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. Liner towards second, and that is through into right field for a single. So the bottom of the inning is still alive after the two-out base hit.
Hey, that's a nice piece of hitting right there. Two-out base knock to put the winning run on base. Let's see if someone can catch a gap and end this thing.
Ready for another shot now. Henry Barrios. He's got a chance to end this one and send these fans home happy if he can get a ball deep enough into the gap. Here's the 2-2 pitch. Just got a piece to the right side. Throw on to first gets him, and the side is retired. So they can't get that winning run home, and that means we'll have to go a little longer tonight to find a winner. Nine can't decide a winner. We'll move ahead to the 10th, all tied at 1-1.
Well, they had to put in a couple of extra innings of work, but hey, listen, a win is a win. And any win is good, especially on the road.
Close one tonight, 2-1 the final score. Andres Machado gets the win in relief, his second of the year. Ronnie Carbajal strikes out the side to record the save, his fourth of the season. So that'll just about do it. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been a presentation of MLB The Show. For more, don't forget to check out theshownation.com.
Our final line score for the victorious Naturals, 2 runs.
Welcome into this presentation of Minor League Baseball from the AA Texas League. Tonight we wrap up this 3-game series between the Northwest Arkansas Naturals and the San Antonio Missions. It's baseball, it's the show, and it comes your way next. Chris Young will do the pitching in Game 3 of the series. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Hey, it's hard to have all four of your pitches on, but I think if this guy can have 2 or 3 of his 4 pitches and have command of them, he's going to have a really good game.
Digging in, Terrence Gore, and we are set for baseball here this evening.
The left fielder, number 1, Terrence Gore.
The 1-1. Hard on the ground to second. Slugger. And an off-balance throw is in time as he takes one away. Wow. Time now to give you a look at the batting order for the visiting squad. Dero, what's the word on this lineup as they go for the series sweep?
Well, Matty, you take a look at this lineup today going against a power arm on the other side. You could see a little bit of ambush tactics employed by this offense in this lineup. Swinging the bat early, not wanting to go to a count where he can rack up a ton of strikeouts. Some early swings out of this lineup.
Throw on to first, and CY's looking for a quick inning here. There are 2 away. And that brings in Hunter Dozier. He did not play last night, but clearly back in the starting 9 for this one. Hit back toward the mound. Slugger ranging up the middle. Throw to first will be in time, and there's 1 gone here to start the 2nd.
All right, here's how the home side's lining up defensively. You want to talk about shutting a running game down? The guy behind the dish has an absolute cannon. I mean, you will not see guys get but 2-step lead off first base today.
Stepping into the box, Professor Leading Slugger is coming off a 3-hit performance in the loss last night.
Professor Slugger.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. Looking at a fastball for a strike on the corner. The windup and the 0-1. One ball and 1 strike to the leadoff man here in the home 3rd. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Fastball stays way up that time for ball 2. And that changeup didn't tempt anybody and misses for ball 3.
It's been a great job so far by the 8-hole hitter. If he finds a way to get on base, this could spell for a huge inning.
The 3-1. Finds the zone to fill the count, 3-2.
We got a full count, 3-2.
Hit in the air out to center field. Whiters waits on it. 1 down. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Professor Slugger. He flew out in his last at bat.
Slugger.
Now the pitch. And this one's nowhere close as that bounces to the plate for ball 1. Runs outside, so it goes to 2-0 now.
That's a good approach when you're facing a young arm you might not be too familiar with. Take a look at a few and see what he's got. Now he's got himself ahead in the count.
2-0 count. The pitch is laid off, but in there for strike one. Fastball is looked at for strike two. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first out.
You know what was really impressive to me about that strikeout? He fell behind 2-0 to start the at-bat. That's a pretty bad place to be, but then he kind of refocused himself and came right back with three quality pitches in a row.
Next will be the cleanup hitter, Hunter Dozier. He got called out on strikes his last time through. His hit to third. Will it be two? To second. On to first, and that's the very last thing they needed at this point in the ball game, as there are quickly two away now.
Well, they got the tying run on base, but one ground ball later, and it's gone. He's going to be frustrated with himself after that.
So a crucial moment here, and standing in, Cliff Whiters. And he does so representing the possible go-ahead run. The 0-2 delivery. Hit ball to second. He's got it. He'll whip this one to first in time, and that ends the inning. So no runs here on a base hit, no errors, and one man left aboard. We'll move on now to the bottom half of the seventh. Get up and stretch. The Missions lead it 2-1. Stepping in, Professor Slugger. It's been an 0-for-2 effort for him to this point.
Slugger.
Here comes the first pitch. Hit back up the middle. A dive, but he can't knock it down. It's through for a base hit. Well, it took him till the seventh, but he gets his first hit of the game here, and that'll extend his hitting streak.
Yeah, and he didn't come out of what he was trying to do all day, Dan. Kept the front shoulder tucked, kept the ice water in his veins, and didn't try and get too big. Extends the hitting streak. Nice job.
You know, D-Row, I talked to him before the game about the streak, and he said the toughest part is he hopes to get hits early in the game to take the pressure off. He had to wait to the seventh inning in this one to come through.
Runner going. Hit hard to third. And that's through for a hit. The throw to third. The tag, and he is out at third base. Cut down, trying to go first to third, and the inning is over. So they pick up no runs on two hits, no errors, and one man left on base. We'll look ahead to inning number eight now. San Antonio's out in front, 2-1. Into the box now, Cam Gallagher. It was a flyout for him in his last trip.
This thing's far from over, even though we're moving into the back end of this game. Only down by one. All they need to do is get this leadoff guy, and they're an extra base hit away from tying this thing up.
Grounded towards second. Slugger is right there. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number eight. Now to the plate, Cliff Whiters. He'll be looking for something he could drive into the gap and drive home that tying run from first. The 1-1. On the ground to short. Could this be two? There's one. Back to first, a double play. And with that, the ball game is over.
Man, they battled right to the end, getting the tying run aboard in the ninth, but that's where the threat ended as they turned a double play to finish this one once and for all.
Close one tonight, 2-1 the final score. The San Antonio Missions led this game from the third inning on and never wavered. Chris Young earns the win, his second, permitting only two hits in six complete innings. Lewis McCoy records the save, his sixth. So that's a wrap for us here tonight. For my partners in the booth, Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. And for more, click over to theshownation.com.
Fans are fun.
Game's future stars are on display as minor league baseball comes your way on the show. Tonight, the first of this four-game weekend set between the San Antonio Missions and the Midland Rockhounds. Midland find themselves on a five-game skid. They'll try to get back on track next. Michael Dye, a lefty from Indiana, is on the mound here. Dan, any thoughts?
Well, as starting pitchers go, he's not real tall. Now, we've seen plenty short guys be very successful, but one of the keys is having good deception by changing speed. The ball doesn't come out from a high angle, so it appears to come in a little flatter. That means pitchers need to come in at different speeds to really fool hitters. We'll see how he does with that here.
The 1-2. Ball to third, and they could get two. Villanueva's got it. Relay to first in time, and just like that, this side is retired. Around the horn they go. 5-4-3 to end the threat. Thursday night baseball rolls on. We'll have more after this. Now at the plate, Professor Slugger. He'll get to take his first cuts here.
Professor Slugger.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. A high fastball is in there. Ready with the nothing and one pitch. And he popped him up. And no one can get there. He'll try it again.
Hey, stay hot now. Nobody better. Nobody better.
Set to deliver on nothing and two. Here it comes.
I got the count.
Can't get him to chase. It's 1-2.
The intent with that changeup away was one thing and one thing only. Get a double play ball. Nice job to lay off it at the plate, though.
The 1-2. Hit fairly well out towards straightaway center. Menzo onto the grass, but he can't make the play as it finds the outfield grass. And that's the second out.
Oh, man, I don't know how that happened. Looked to be a base hit to the outfield, but then all of a sudden the throw comes in and they get the force on the play. To be honest, that just can't happen.
Digging in the switch hitter, Jeff Norris, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Slugger is off of first with two away. And he'll step off and fire to the bag. And he'll dive back in.
One time, right now.
0-1 count. Here's the pitch. Runners on the move for second. This is on the ground over to first. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. One hit, one left. On now to the bottom of the second. The Missions lead it 1-0. Now at the plate, Billy Whitmore, as they'll have 5, 6, and 7 here to start the home half of the second.
Billy Whitmore.
Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Towards second. Slugger is up with it. Throw on to first in time, one away.
All right, here's how the visitors are lining up today. And fellas, when you take a look at the numbers on this guy, this starting pitcher has a low ERA, a low strikeout rate. And what that means to me, obviously he has an amazing rapport with his catcher, working all quadrants, east, west, north, south. But it also means that his defense does some serious nice cleaning for him.
Now batting, Professor
now batting.
Slugger.
Second baseman, Professor Slugger.
First offering on its way. There's a strike.
You know, Matty, when I first broke into the league, you wouldn't see that high heater first pitch right out of the gate. But I think there's been a change in philosophy here. Back in the late 90s, early 2000s, guys wanted to attack you more east-west, get you leaning left-right. Now you're seeing guys attacking the philosophy more north-south. Just with launch angles and exit velocities, I think guys are afraid to throw that sinking fastball for fear that guys are just going to run their barrel into it. Not the case with the high fastball.
Fox is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. So it's two runs here on two hits, with one of them being the home run. To the bottom of inning number four we go. San Antonio's out in front, 3-0. Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, Eric Manzo. He singled in two trips to the plate thus far. Hit hard on the ground is short. To second for one, on to first, and they turn the double play.
Really good pitch from the pitcher right there. Down in the zone, hits on top of it, induces the ground ball double play.
Digging in to try it again, now Professor
back.
Slugger.
Second
he flew
baseman.
Out in his last
Professor
at-bat.
Slugger.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. And there's a sinker that he just spits on as it misses low. Now a ball slapped hard the opposite way. And that'll get down for a base hit. And they've really got something going here. Runners at second and third to start the inning. Well, it took him till the seventh, but he gets his first hit of the game here, and that'll extend his hitting streak.
Yeah, and he didn't come out of what he was trying to do all day, Dan. Kept the front shoulder tucked, kept the ice water in his veins, and didn't try and get too big. Extends the hitting streak. Nice job.
You know, D-Row, I talked to him before the game about the streak, and he said the toughest part is he hopes to get hits early in the game to take the pressure off. He had to wait to the seventh inning in this one to come through.
Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 0-2 pitch. And a swing and a miss. A big strikeout here as it'll remain second and third, but with one away now.
Really impressive pitching right there. Sometimes as a pitcher, you can get frustrated when you make a good pitch and you don't get that call from the umpire. But what does he do? He comes back with a good pitch and gets the strike.
How about him? The center fielder.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Henry Barrios. He comes in 0-2 thus far. The 1-2 is swung on and missed. He got him.
That's a pretty impressive pitch from a young arm like that. If you could spot your pitches there in advantage counts like 1-2, you're going to have a lot of strikeouts and soft contact.
Now back to the top of the lineup. Now stepping in, Oswaldo Chacin, as the switch hitter will take his cuts left-handed here.
This is somewhat of a cause for concern. This guy needs to hit better left-handed against right-handed pitching.
In the air out to left. Whitmore is there, and he puts this one away for the third out. So a great job there of working out a potential trouble. So it's no runs on two hits, no errors, and two men left stranded. Seventh inning stretch time here at the ballpark. The Missions lead it 3-0. Ready for another chance? Professor Slugger. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here. Now here's the pitch. Breaking ball for a strike. 0-1.
Hey, your pitch. Drive it deep, huh? Here you go.
Up around the face. With this one almost in the books, the story was clearly the long ball. What are your thoughts on this offense, fellas?
Well, Matty V, I don't know what your thoughts are, D-Roll, but boy, when the weather starts to warm up and the ball starts jumping out like this, it's clear that the pitchers need to start making better pitches.
Yeah, just great approach. No one really chased today. Really stayed staunch on their ability to get that pitcher to come into the heart of the plate, and they did damage with it.
Popped him up. Lopez is under it. He's got it one away. Digging in once again, Ronaldo Arturo.
Left fielder.
Whitmore aboard here at first with nobody out. This is hit not all that hard out to second. Reined in. He will go to shortstop covering, and they do get the force at second. That was not an easy play.
You know, it's always nice to get that first one under your belt when you start a four-game series on the road. It takes a little bit of the wind out of the sails of the guys in the home dugout and gives you confidence to come back and do it again tomorrow.
5-2, the final score tonight. The San Antonio Missions jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. Grover Lloyd wins his third of the season. So that just about does it. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way on over to theshownation.com. Minor League Baseball is live and on the air on the show. Tonight it's the third of this four-game weekend series between the San Antonio Missions and the Midland Rockhounds. Midland hope to put a lid on their seven-game losing streak. Coming up next. Ray Lucero, a Massachusetts-born right-hander, will get the start in this one. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Hey, it's hard to have all four of your pitches on, but I think if this guy can have two or three of his four pitches and have command of them, he's going to have a really good game.
Digging in, Professor Slugger is back in the starting lineup for this one after sitting out last night's game. Throw over to first, and he's back in standing. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Good-looking sinker on the inside corner. Clearly trying to control the running game with the slide step here.
Yeah, that's a good way of trying to control the running game, Matt. The problem with it, though, it has a tendency to throw your command off because you're worrying about that runner on base.
On its way, the 0-1 pitch. Hit in the air to right field. In there, a base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
Hey, Dan, as a former pitcher, that knock just took him to a 12-game hit streak. Is that in the packet when you're looking over the lineup?
Hey, there's no doubt about that, D-Row. You go into a pitcher's meeting, and they're making fully aware of who's hot and who's not. And trust me, they knew that he had an 11-game hitting streak. And after that knock, it's an even dozen.
Coming to the plate now, Henry Barrios. And he could give his guys an early lead if he can come through here. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Chopped weakly to the left. Gonna be a tough play. They'll force it up to second, and they do get the out there. Striding in once again, Professor Slugger. He reached on a single in his first try.
Slugger.
A Here comes the first pitch. Popped him up. And this is going to get down. It's a foul ball. Set to deliver the 0-1. Strike two at a pitch that catches the outside corner.
Hey, come on now. One time. Right here.
Looking to put him away. Here's the 0-2.
One ball.
Missed with a breaking ball.
Those 0-2 curveballs are really tough for guys to lay off. There's a reason it's such a common pitch in that count, but he did well to spit on it there.
The 1-2. And he gets under this one as the ball is skied into very shallow right. Eubanks will stay with it as he backs up and puts it away. One gone. Ready for another shot now. Dana Ibar, already two for two. We'll look to add on right here.
Ibar.
From the belt, kicks and deals. Pitch down that swung on and sent to second base. Throw to first in time, and the big inning is avoided as the side is retired. So all in all, they're fortunate to give up just three in the inning as they wind up escaping the bases loaded jam. We're through five here at the ballpark, and we are all tied at three apiece. Ready once again, Professor Slugger. A hit in two tries so far.
Slugger.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. Hit on the ground out to short. Ibar scoops it up. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth. Digging in and looking for more, Benito Lopez. He's one for two in the ballgame. Medrano stands at second with no outs. Grounded back up the middle. Slugger has it, and there's one away. So stepping in, Professor Slugger. He got on top of one. It was a ground out victim last time.
Slugger.
Comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. And that slider's almost in the dirt.
This is a critical point right here. Things are in danger of getting away from him a little, so we'll see how he deals with it.
Hey, come on, big guy. Get here.
The 1-0. Lifted into the air out towards center field. Smolinski patrolling center makes the play. One out. Standing in, Dana Ibar. And Dan, what's the plan of attack here for the guy on the mound?
Well, I think they have to go right after him. He's pretty unlikely to take you deep. But if you allow him to get on base, the chances of him scoring and tying this game become a lot greater.
Here's the pitch on 2-2. Side. Gets through for a base hit. He's now 3-for-4 in this one.
Well, I think it's safe to say the ice has melted on this guy. He had been cold coming into this game, but that being his third knock, I guarantee you my man's smiling on the inside.
Now at the plate, Bo Fox, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third. Breaking ball swung on and grounded to second. Slugger, throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. So a run on one hit, no errors, and a man left. We've played eight full. San Antonio's out in front, 5-4.
Hey,
Now in the box, Professor Slugger. He flew out in his last at bat.
Slugger.
Hey, let it fly.
Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. And a fastball just a bit high. Torres over at second. Rosales at first, two out in the inning. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. Looking up is Smolinski. And goodbye. This one ain't coming back. So a three-run shot to left center, second home run early in the year, and they double him up. It's 8-4.
You know, as a pitcher, there's nothing worse than getting taken deep, but it's something every pitcher has to deal with. Even the best pitchers give up home runs. You just have to refocus. Well, in hindsight, it was the right choice to let the setup guy stay in the game and finish this thing. I wasn't so sure before, but the results sure speak for themselves.
8-4 tonight. The Missions came through late, taking the lead in the eighth to secure the victory. Stefan Crichton claims the win out of the pen, his first. Corey Place works two full innings in relief to record the save, his first of the year. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, this is Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter at MLB The Show.
Fans, our final line score, first for the victorious Mission. 8 runs.
Minor League Baseball now on the show as our road trip makes a stop in the Double-A Texas League. Tonight, game four of this four-game weekend set between the San Antonio Missions and the Midland Rockhounds. Midland go to work on ending what's become an eight-game skid. First pitch is next. Daniel Gossett, a hurler from South Carolina, will be the starting pitcher in this one. Dan, any thoughts?
Well, this guy certainly could be one of those horses for courses kind of guy. Loves pitching at home. Take a look at those home road splits. They're pretty good. Without question, he's more comfortable pitching at home than he is on the road.
Stepping into the box, Professor Slugger. It was a two-hit effort for him, including a home run in last night's game. Here's the first pitch to him. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Smolinski is camped under this one, and that's out number two. Ready now, Professor Slugger. He flew out in his last at bat.
Professor Slugger.
Let's go, kid. Here we go.
First pitch on its way.
Yeah.
A high fastball is in there.
You know, Matty, when I first broke into the league, you wouldn't see that high heater first pitch right out of the gate. But I think there's been a change in philosophy here. Back in the late 90s, early 2000s, guys wanted to attack you more east-west, get you leaning left-right. Now you're seeing guys attack in the philosophy more north-south. Just with launch angles and exit velocities, I think guys are afraid to throw that sinking fastball for fear that guys are just going to run their barrel into it. Not the case with the high fastball.
The 1-1. Skied in the air to straightaway left. And there's out number two as this is taken in shy of the track and the runner will have to retreat. Now to the plate, Billy Whitmore. 0-for-1 for him here in this one.
Third baseman, Billy Whitmore.
Towards second, Slugger fields it clean. Throws in time, and that's out number one. So striding forward now, Professor Slugger. He's 0-for-2 thus far in this one.
Here we go, one time, like a big dog.
Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch.
1-0.
And here's a slider that's nowhere close, and it's 1-0. And he watches one miss outside, 2-0 now.
Well, he's got a base open to use right here, and it looks like he might not be afraid to do that by the way he's pitching him.
Working to keep them in the game here. And this is lifted high in the air down the right field line. And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. So they pick up a run on two hits, no errors, and a man left. Part of the order, 3, 4, and 5 coming up. The Missions lead it 2-1. Striding into the box, Professor Slugger. He's now hitless coming into this at-bat, so the hit streak he's been riding is on the line here.
Yeah, he's up in the double digits with it. You know he wants to keep it going as long as possible, but this very well could be the last chance to do that.
Here we go.
He's set. Here it comes. Hit the other way out toward right field. Stewart ranging into the outfield. He can't get to it. This one's down. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now. So he waited till the ninth inning, but he comes through here to extend the hit streak. That was close.
Yeah, Matty B, you see that wry smile of him coming out of the box right there? He knew what was on the line. He'd be lying if he didn't.
There's a lot of pressure on you because you're walking into that batter's box thinking, I have a nice streak going, and this is more than likely going to be my last AB. He comes Henry through in the clutch.
Mario.
Ground ball, left side. And that is through into left field, a base hit. Throw comes in quickly here, and that'll prevent the runner at third from testing things here.
Boy, Dero, we're looking at a big inning right here with that single. Bases are loaded, yet no runs have scored in this inning.
Yeah, and that's exactly what that pitcher wants you to think. You have to eliminate the noise, Dan. Just try and drive in the guy from third base. Don't put pressure on yourself that you have to get everyone in with one swing of the bat. Pass the baton and keep the line moving.
Fly ball out to straightaway right. Fox waits on it, makes the catch, but the runner from third breaks for home. And now this is thrown wildly, just getting it into the infield. And he is in there. So problems out there in right field as this is going to wind up going as an E9. Stepping in, Frank Rivera, 0-for-3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. And this is swung on and missed, so they come right after him, and it remains second and third, but with two away now.
That's the third time in this game he's gone down on strikes. Not the game he was hoping to have when he was taking batting practice, but at least his guys are ahead.
At the plate, Oswaldo Chacin, who looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Chacin.
Trying to keep the deficit right where it is, the pitch. And he takes ball four. So now at least they're set up for the force at any base here with two away.
These guys on defense are still within striking distance, but after that walk, one swing of the bat could really blow this thing wide open.
Stepping into the box, Matt Caesar. He's got three hits, including a double to this point. Slugger on third, Barrios on second, Chacin on at first with two down. And that misses. Ball four. A run will come in to score.
Man, when you're trailing, you hate to give up any runs, but walking one in is especially painful. Now the lead is extended and a base hit could blow the lid right off this thing. Well, maybe a little bit of a problem is that they had to wind up going to that bullpen quite a bit. Five pitchers are going to combine to finish this one to get the win.
And tonight's ends at a 6-2 finish. The Missions wrote an important sixth inning to victory in this one. Brian Mitchell earns his first win of the season. So that'll just about do it. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been a presentation of MLB The Show. For more, don't forget to check out theshownation.com.
Fans, our final line score, first for the victorious mission. 6 runs.
Which clues in a new team member on available resources.
Real topics, even while Will stop it, chills watching.